Hello everybody, Mobius One here, bringing you the first profession guide in quite a while. I'm actually bringing you this video from the character that I started my Galaxy series with, Fenadin. Now Fenadin really hasn't been used at all. I wanted to leave this tune as fresh as possible, just in case I wanted to do something like a typical Let's Play or something along those lines. But today, we're going to be using Fenadin in a Scout profession guide. So, some of you who follow my channel more regularly have heard me say that I planned on doing more profession guides, and I was probably going to be starting with the starter professions. And, well, here it is. So, I already have a medic guide on the channel. You guys can probably just check out my Galaxy's playlist to find that. We're going to try knocking out the rest of the starter professions relatively soon, but today we're going to be focusing on Scout. So first of all, what do we need to know about Scout? Scout is a very critical profession in Star Wars Galaxies. It's not really a combat profession. It's definitely more of a utility profession. So if you plan on having a combat character, Scout really isn't a priority for you, though it is required to get to some pretty interesting combat professions. For example, Bounty Hunter, which is arguably the most popular combat profession. You do need the Exploration branch of the Scout profession. Creature Handler needs both the Exploration and the Hunting branch. Ranger is the elite profession, which you need Master Scout for. And while it may not be a popular choice, it is worth noting that Squad Leader requires the Exploration and the Survival branch. Bioengineer also needs the Hunting branch of Scout. So Scout leads to many different types of professions. You've got everything here from crafting, from bioengineer, group support, squad leader, and combat, bounty hunter, and creature handler. And then ranger, really, I'm just going to say this now. Ranger, doing a ranger guide would actually be a little bit redundant. Mainly because the ranger profession and the scout profession, they all have the grind is exactly the same. So for Scout, let's take a look at our four branches. We have Exploration, Trapping, Hunting, and Survival. So the Exploration branch and the Hunting branch actually both share experience types. Both of those branches require scouting experience. The Trapping branch requires trapping experience. And the Survival branch requires wilderness survival experience. Now, before we even go into details on those, I just want to show you. Ranger, look at this. Wayfaring needs scouting. Tracking needs scouting. Advanced trapping needs trapping. And frontiering needs wilderness survival. So while the order is a little bit different, the four branches in the ranger tree are pretty much identical to the four branches in the scout tree. So if you can master scout, you can master ranger. It's just the XP caps are a little bit higher. Anyway, and I am kind of winging this video, and I am by no means a professional at this. So if I say anything in this guide that you disagree with, or if I fail to mention something, or if there's a better way to do something than a way that I offer, I want you guys to, instead of getting mad and raging at me in the comments, as I'm sure some of you would, I'd much rather you just be like, hey, Mobius, at this time, whatever in the video, you said this, when in actuality it's this instead. And I would be more than happy to do a little annotation in the video and credit you for the information, because these resources are here for new players, not for me to show off my lack of knowledge on the game. Anyway, so what do we get as a novice scout? Well, first of all, if you start the game as a scout, which we did not, Fenadin started as a marksman. But if you do start as a scout, I believe everybody gets a Mirage Melon. I believe, as far as weapons go, I believe they give you a survival knife and a CDEF pistol. It might just be the survival knife, but I'm pretty sure they give you the pistol too. You also get a generic crafting tool, which this is going to be very important to you if you plan on being a scout, because you're going to need to be making traps and camps. If you start as a profession other than scout and decide later on to pick up scout, this is something you're going to want to buy, immediately. And I think I showed in my medic video also how to get this, or if you're already familiar with shopping, this information is going to be a little bit redundant to you, but since these guides are geared towards new players, I'm just going to show you. If you do need to buy something at any point in this guide, or at any point during your grind, you're going to look for a bank in one of the major cities. So the bank, all the bank complexes look like this kind of mazy thing. Alternatively, you type /find bank, and it will take you, you'll get a little waypoint that points you in the right direction, and you come right here. But really what you're looking for is a bazaar terminal. So you're going to use the bazaar terminal, you're going to double click on tool, and you're going to click on crafting tool. And you should be able to find just about, as long as you're in Mos Eisley, Feed, or Coronet, you should be able to find generic crafting toolkits. So let's just see. Food and chemical, there actually aren't any generic ones here, so I was wrong. But actually, a weapon droid and general item crafting tool would work also. So either one of those would do you good. So, once you have that, you may also... let me see. If you're making camps, we'll get into the camp making a little bit later. So, let's look at the three XP types that we're going to need. Again, are scouting, wilderness survival, and trapping. The scouting XP is probably what most people are going to be interested in, because most people are probably going for creature handler or bounty hunter. So, and the two of those are actually the easiest to get, but you're going to need to pair it with some sort of combat profession. So even if you plan on being a Master Ranger, since Scout and Ranger don't have any combat abilities on their own, you're going to want to pick up either Brawler or Marksman just to get some basic combat skills. Now, Fenadin here, if we look at Marksman, he's got Rifles 1 and Range Support 1. So we're roughly able to survive against some things. So this rock mite over here, not a great example because it's a rock mite, but let's find something else. Hopefully we can find a dune lizard or something. Rock mites, Jawa warlord, Jawa engineer, rock mite, minor wart, good enough. Oh, there's a lizard. It's a rill. I'd rather get the warts. Alright. So, when you kill something... Oops. Okay. When you kill something, if you click and hold to bring up the radio menu on the corpse, if it's a creature, you'll notice that you can't loot it. If you go to loot, there's nothing there. You don't get credits. You don't get drops. However, if you have Novice Scout, you will have a third option to harvest resources which other professions don't get. And when you hover your cursor, now remember, I'm clicking and holding. If you just go over to Harvest Resources and let go of your mouse, you're going to get a random resource, and that's not what you want to do. You just want to hold your mouse, and you can then choose specifically whether you want to harvest meat, hide, or bone. Now, we're going to go with hide. All right, so it says you receive 1 unit of Tatooinean leathery hide. The creature is scrawny and unhealthy. You receive 44 points of scouting experience. So there we go. We just gained some scout XP. Now, I already have Hunting 1 on here because I had played on this character a little bit before, but pretty much Exploration 1 and Hunting 1 require 1,000 points of scouting XP. So all you need to do to level these is just run around and kill things. And honestly, if you're working on a profession like Bounty Hunter or even some other combat profession and you get creature missions, this is all you have to do. It's that easy. You're going to be killing things anyway, so you might as well harvest them. And being completely honest, if you don't even know what professions you really want to go for yet, it's not a bad idea to pick up Scout and do this anyway, even if you end up surrendering it later, because you're going to be killing the things while you work on your combat profession. You might as well get the extra resources, because just about any resource can sell on the bazaar for 1 credit per unit. So it's almost like an extra source of income. So that was Tatooine Bristlyhide. You notice I got 2 units off of that one. So a couple different things affect how many resources you get from harvesting a creature. Primarily, or the main thing that affects it, is your creature harvesting skill mod, which you gain by leveling up the hunting tree. So the higher creature harvesting skill you have, the more resources you'll get per harvest. The next biggest thing is probably whether it's the creature was scrawny or unhealthy, or if it was fat and healthy, or medium size. There's a whole bunch of different ratings that the creatures can be, and those are actually determined by geographical location. So you'll notice every time I kill something here, it's scrawny and unhealthy, and that will never change until the resource shifts. Just like the resources that you survey for as an artisan, just like they change positions every couple of days, the resource spawns for these creature resources will also move over time. So while one area like this may be scrawny and unhealthy now, it's possible that at some point in the future we'll be able to get fat and healthy creatures there, which will increase our resource harvesting yield. There's also a food that you can buy called veg hash that gives you a bonus modifier to creature harvesting. So if I consume one of these babies, let us now kill this wart, which earlier warts were giving us, this guy's AFK macroing, okay. Warts were giving us 1 unit of hide per kill, and you'll notice I'm accumulating these in my inventory here. We're going to be using those shortly. Here's a bunch of warts. Okay. I still got one. So the plus 29 wasn't that big of a deal for warts. However, the larger the creature, the more of a resource you're also going to get. So these warts are pretty tiny, insignificant little creatures. But if you were to go to Naboo and kill, say, Fombas, those giant four-legged creatures, you would get many, many, many more units of resource per harvest than I am off these little dinky guys. So it's kind of something I said in my money-making video, because I get asked a lot, what's the quickest way to make money in galaxies? And short answer to that was, master your combat profession, because it's a lot easier to make money as a master combat profession than it is while you're still grinding. It's kind of the same for Scout. It's a lot easier to get resources in mass quantities after you've mastered Scout, or even Ranger for that matter, than it is while you're still grinding the profession. So you really shouldn't be... I'm not telling you... I'm struggling to find the right words here. I'm not saying you shouldn't try to collect as many resources as you can as you're still grinding Scout, but it's going to be much easier after you've mastered the profession, so you really shouldn't care what you're harvesting until you reach that point. That being said, if you are going for Master Scout and the ranger profession, you're going to need to do more than just killing things and harvesting them. You're going to need trapping and survival. Now, these are kind of unique in galaxies, because there's very specific methods of getting these. So trapping is actually pretty straightforward, and it's actually rather easy. So now that you have your generic crafting toolkit, and you have some resources, and luckily I've had resources in here from before, if you go ahead and double-click on your generic crafting toolkit, you're going to have different categories here. And if you're not familiar with crafting in galaxies, I highly recommend you go watch my crafting tutorial. But even if you're not And even if you're not planning on being a crafter full-time, it's good to know this. So you're going to go to miscellaneous. And what do you know? Basic camp kit's the first thing, but that's not what we're making yet. We're going to scroll down to trap. Now, as a novice scout, we only have the schematics to make two different traps. You have the wire mesh trap and the lecithinine dart. And every trap in the game does something different. So if we read these, wire mesh trap, a small canister packed with a fine and somewhat sticky mesh. When it strikes the target, the mesh entangles them, making movement more difficult. This has the effect of making the target easier to hit with melee attacks. And the lecithinine dart, a small dart delivery system, ingeniously crafted from natural organics. The tip is coated with a light lecithinine poison. The object is thrown at a target in combat. If it hits, the poison will cause the target to become drowsy and slightly confused. This has the effect of making the target dizzy, as well as causing a slight decrease in the target's action pool. This weapon cannot kill and only works on animals. So, we're going to make both of these. And you'll notice both of them require 3 units of bone and hide. So you're going to want to get both of these as your resource gathering. So if I double click on the wire mesh trap, here's all of our resources. It actually doesn't matter what the quality of the resources is. Normally, it would tell us down here, you know, what percentage of what stat of the resource is required. But none of that is here at all. So it has absolutely no matter what the stats are. And because of that, the crummier the resource is, the better it is for making traps. So you actually want to use your lowest quality resources. And I mean, nothing that I have here is really that great. But just to give you an example, like this leathery hide here has an overall quality of 559. Now I know overall quality isn't the most important stat depending on what you're trying to make, but it is generally important for pretty much everything. So, because this has an OQ of 559, and this has an OQ of 155, I want to use this to craft the traps, because it's not going to have any impact on the final result. Likewise with the bone, this has an OQ of 510, this one's 139, so we're going to use this. Once you've plugged the resources in, you're going to click Assemble, yes. You're going to go through all the phases. You're going to click Create Object. You do not want to do this in practice mode. Even though practice mode will give you more XP for crafting, you don't get a finished product. Now, one thing I do want to point out is as soon as you finish crafting that trap, I actually gained 12 points of wilderness survival XP. So that crafting traps is actually one way, a very slow way, but it is one way to level your survival branch. And we're going to come back to that later on. So now I have the wire mesh trap in my inventory. If I go find something to use it on, which we can't use evil settlers, can't use a criminal, we used a diseased bowcat. That's probably not a great target. I don't know if I can handle him. Is he stalking me? No. Alright, let's go back and see if we can find those warts or those rock mites. Here we go. So by targeting the wart, you can actually put these traps on your quick bar and then just press that corresponding button to use the trap. Now that trap hit and I got 90 points of trapping XP. If I try to use it again so early, it will say the trap failed to affect the target. Now, what you're looking for is if you look in the top right corner or wherever your target's little this is, their handbars, you'll see when I use the trap on the target, they get this little debuff here. It says immobilized. You cannot hit, well, two traps of the same type will not stack. So basically, you need to wait until that icon disappears like it did just now before you can use the trap again. And you'll see, as long as that thing disappears, now your traps, they do have a chance of missing, but for the most part, you can throw as many traps at one target as you want. See, that one failed to affect the target, and I'm out of traps, so I need to just kill this guy. And again, don't forget to harvest them after you kill them to get more resources, which you can use to build more traps. Alright, and just from that, Look, I've already got a good chunk of my trapping one skill done just from those two creatures. So, we're going to make some more traps. This time, I'm going to make one of this wire mesh trap. And I'm going to make a lecithinian dart. Alright, I'm going to put my wire mesh trap here. And I'm going to put my lecithinian dart trap here. So now when we target, we'll use the wire mesh trap. There's 90 points of trapping experience, followed immediately by the lecithinian dart trap. The trap hits, but poison has no effect on a wart. Alright, so unfortunately this particular creature type is immune to poisons. But normally, we'll try and find another creature to use that on. Normally, you can get, since the traps do different effects, you can apply more than one at a time on a creature. Now, similarly to harvesting resources, the larger the creature you use your trap on, the more points of trapping XP you get. It is possible, if you have a friend or an alt that's very tanky, if you can get them to hold the aggro of a crate dragon for you, you can level your entire trapping branch off of one crate dragon just by throwing traps at it over and over again. Now, obviously, you would have to go back and train your skills once you hit caps, but it is still possible to do. So you can see there I got the lecithinian dart to stick. There I got the wire mesh to stick. The lecithinian dart wore off, so I threw that again. And I'm just going to stand here and wait. I'm watching the icons. There, the wire mesh trap wore off. So I'm going to throw another one if I hit the right button. There, the wire mesh, or the lecithinian wore off, so I throw one of them. That missed. Oh, it says it had no effect on a reel, but it worked before. There we go. That worked, and now I'm out of traps, so I kill the reel. Harvest it for more. And just like that, look, I'm almost done with trapping one, and it took three creatures. That's it. So that's really all you need to know about trapping. Now, as you get higher in the trapping branch, you actually unlock schematics for different trap types. Guess what that means? That means after you learn trapping one, you can now make wire mesh traps, lecithinian dart traps, sharp bone spur traps, and glow juice traps, and you can use all four on the same creature at the same time to get even faster trapping XP. So the trapping branch actually becomes easier to grind the higher you go. That's how amazing it is. Actually, while we have this open, let's look at what we get from the other branches, because I should have gone over that earlier. So the exploration branch in Scout, primarily used for terrain negotiation. So what is terrain negotiation? Terrain negotiation affects the player's ability to move in rough terrain. From 0 to 50, this skill increases the player's ability to move up slopes quickly. From 50 to 100, this skill increases the player's ability to move fast while prone. Now, we get plus... no, we don't get any terrain negotiation as a novice scout. Do we get it just... No, alright, fine. Okay, so from 0 to 50, it's how quickly you can move up slopes. Now, you've probably already seen what it's like to try to run up a slope. So, let's just demonstrate that really quickly. If I try to go straight up this slope here, I slow to basically a crawling speed. Now, it doesn't make a huge difference, just the first skill of exploration, so I'm not going to waste my time going back to town and showing you what it looks like after you train the skill, but that's basically what this is. The higher your terrain negotiation skill, the quicker you can go up slopes, and while I'm not 100%, somebody can comment and confirm or deny this, I believe that also affects you when you're on a vehicle. So I think if you have a higher terrain negotiation, even while you're on your mount, it still increases the speed at which you go up slopes. So that's Exploration 1, you get a good chunk of that. Exploration 2, you get You get a new ability called Mask Scent, which we'll talk about a little bit later. You get a plus 20 modifier for it, and you also get plus 20 Burst Run Efficiency. It says the Burst Run Efficiency skill mod is a direct percentage decreased to the cost of using the Burst Run command. So when you use Burst Run, it actually takes away 300, is it, from all three pools? Yeah, it takes away 300 health, 300 action, and 300 mind by default. So with Exploration 2, you get 20% cost reduction in the use of that ability. Exploration 3, here's another plus 20 terrain negotiation, which brings your skill now for terrain negotiation up to 40, and some extra modifiers for Mask Scent. Excuse me. Exploration 4 takes another 20% off of the cost of Burst Run and gives you a huge increase in your Mask Scent. So what is Mask Scent? Mask Scent is an ability that masks your scent from aggressive creatures for a short time. It doesn't work 100% of the time, and obviously the higher your Mask Scent skill is, the more often it's going to work. But there's an even bigger reason why Mask Scent is important for grinding Scout, and that's because every time Mask Scent succeeds a roll against a creature, so every time you have Mask Scent on and a creature performs check to see if it detects you, if it fails to detect you because of Mask Scent, you actually get scouting experience. So just by running around with Mask Scent on while you're doing missions or while you're harvesting creatures, you're going to be collecting small amounts but bonus scouting XP. So it's worth having that on as soon as you pick it up, because it'll make grinding the rest of these two branches quicker. Do we get anything good at Novice Scout that's worth mentioning? Not really. Hunting, we already talked about the further up the hunting branch you go, you get more creature harvesting, so you can harvest more units per harvest. You also get more creature knowledge. Now, this is kind of an interesting thing. Creature knowledge, it says when a player with creature knowledge examines a creature, they learn additional information about the creature's abilities. The higher the skill mod, the more information displayed. So that means when I actually go to the examine option on one of these creatures, you'll see here, I can see a Tempest Drill has an armor rating of none. It's vulnerable to both stun and lightsaber damage types. It's aggressive. It's not a stalker, and it's tameable. Now, the higher creature knowledge skill mod I have, the more information will display here. You'll notice I can't see what its armor resistances is. Armor resistances are to all of the different damage types, like kinetic, electricity, energy, heat, cold. I can't see that. But once you go up further in the hunting tree, or hunting branch, all of that information and some more interesting stuff, like whether or not the creature will death blow, I think whether or not they're pack animals, because some animals will attack in packs. There might be some other interesting things that I can't think of right now, but all that information will be displayed here. You also, every once in a while, I guess just in hunting too, you get a creature to hit bonus. It says skilled scouts and rangers have gained the ability to strike creatures more efficiently or effectively. This raw to hit bonus only applies to normal ranged attacks. So that, it's important to note that, because that shows you that while Scout is a utility profession, and technically you can pair this with any combat profession, this two-hit bonus, while it's only a plus 10 and it's the only bonus that you get, it only applies to ranged attacks. So if you pair this with like Terras Kasi or Swordsman or any of the brawler professions, you're not going to be taking advantage of this creature-to-hit bonus. Is that a big deal? Not really. I mean, if you're a Master Terras Kasi, a plus 10 on your to-hit bonus is not going to make or break you. But it's worth noting. And really, all that leaves us with is survival. I just want to take a look and see, what do we get at Master Scout? We get another plus 10 Burst Run Efficiency, more creature harvesting, more creature knowledge, more Mask Scent. There's your last plus 10 terrain negotiation, so that would take you up to 50. So I guess if you need even more terrain negotiation, do you not? Oh, they're wayfaring. Alright, so yeah, you do go above 50 terrain negotiation if you go into Ranger. That should be plus another 50. No, you just get 40? 20 and 20? Alright, whatever. Unless you get 10 from Novice Ranger, which you did. Oh, no, you get 5. 95. Alright. So yeah. Survival. This is arguably the worst part of your scout grind. So yeah, so that just leaves survival, and since survival is such a unique thing, and because I get asked this question a lot, I'm actually going to make the survival portion of this scout guide in a separate video so that I can link just that to people that ask me specifically about camping. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this scout guide so far. Check out part 2, the link will be in the description, and I'll see you guys there.